media, in the end, is an instrument. That's by definition, media is an instrument. He said, what we've seen, I think, that's interesting to me in recent months is that it's been an instrument that is adapted to a very dynamic situation, very different situations in Egypt, in Libya, in Syria. And in a way, you know, you've seen different combinations of media interacting with each other, telephones to internet, internet to satellite, so on, you know, things being uploaded. But the problem with new media, I think, is to answer your question, new media, of course, doesn't play the traditional, or it's more difficult, let me put it that way, to, in the aftermath of the revolution, to watch what's going on, you know, to supervise, to hold accountable traditional government institutions. It's not as easy to do that on Twitter as it is, or on web, or on blogs, as it is, for example, more traditional media like television, newspapers. If I could defend newspapers just a little bit, although in the Middle East, to be honest, it's, you know, there's not that much to defend. But I come from a country where newspapers, which are not read in Lebanon, probably all newspapers sell less than 100,000 all combined, probably closer to 70,000. And yet there is still a legitimacy to newspapers. Something appears in a newspaper, it's given credit. So if, in a way, if you want to hold accountable the institutions of government, I think it's important. Obviously, television is number one, but it is important that this also be a newspaper. New media doesn't really have much of a role to play in that. But I think, I mean, you know, I agree with you. I think, to a certain extent, this whole debate about new media, I was before coming to this panel, I was wondering, well, this is very much a Western debate, irrelevant to us, or not that relevant to us in the Middle East. But I think, no, I actually don't think that's the case. My predecessor was saying that Al Jazeera challenged the traditional narrative. Actually, what Al Jazeeera did is rewrote the narrative. And in a sense, that's extremely powerful in politics. And I think that, you know, these traditional media, as we go back to, you know, to re-establishing post-revolutionary orders, if the revolution is indeed taking place, we will go back to traditional instruments. But again, you know, where are these systems going? I have absolutely no confidence. Political parties, as we know, take a place like Egypt, there's an element of discredit there. In Libya, we don't really have that type of structure. So, you know, I prefer to keep the debate on media. I think one thing we will see, if I may just toss this in at the end, you know, no one ever speaks about Iraq anymore. But you know, one of the first things that came out of the Iraq war was a plurality of media in Iraq. Now, do people follow the media? It's very politicized, it's very dynamic, though at the same time, I think one of the things to watch for in a country like Libya today, for example, Tunisia, is what, you know, what is the aftermath of the media? You suddenly have plurality of access, of outlets that